for news from India, America, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I am Rishika and today's headlines are: In India, the opposition has slammed an MHA order over intercepting all computers, and the Delhi High Court has directed a Congress-owned newspaper to vacate its premises within 2 weeks. In America, Defense Secretary James Mattis has resigned, and the US will withdraw 7,000 troops from Afghanistan. In Punjab, our SAD MP called for the British government apology over the Jallianwala Bagh massacre, and CM Amrinder Singh has urged SAD President Sukhbir Singh Badal to stop political hatred. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, America and Punjab. For detailed news and businesses updates of the Indo-American community, download the Indian Times Daily app. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: 10 central agencies have been authorized by the center to intercept information from any computer. The move has set off a political storm with the opposition, accusing the government of trying to create a surveillance state. The center defended the move, saying that it was a mere repetition of an order framed during the UP regime in 2009. The Associated Journals Limited, the publisher of Congress mouthpiece National Herald, has been directed by the Delhi High Court to vacate its premises in the national capital within 2 weeks. It noted that the place was not being used for the purpose it was leased out for. BJP President Amit Shah has said that India has seen only two insecure dictators, one who imposed emergency and the other who wanted unrestricted access to the letters of common sense. He was hitting back at Congress President Rahul Gandhi over his insecure dictator bar with Prime Minister Narendra Modi. All 22 accused in the Sohrabuddin Sheikh encounter case have been acquitted by a special CBI court due to lack of evidence. The alleged gangster was killed in a farmhouse on November 26, 2005 and his body dumped on the road. His wife, Kausar B, was allegedly killed 3 days later and her body burned. A division bench of the Calcutta High Court has quashed a single bench order that had allowed BJP's Rath Yatra in West Bengal. The court asked it to hear the case afresh to consider intelligence inputs by state agencies. There have been apprehensions of communal unrest during the BJP's proposed roadshow. The Delhi High Court has directed authorities to immediately release former youth Congress leader Sushil Sharma. He was serving a life sentence for killing his wife Naina Sahani in 1995. The bench asked whether a person could be kept in prison indefinitely for the offence of murder, even if he has already served his sentence. Two soldiers have been killed in suspected sniper fire along the LOC in Kupwara district of Jammu and Kashmir. Defence sources said that Pakistan violated the ceasefire in Jammu sector, leading to the fatality. Banking services across India were affected on Friday. This was after over 3.2 lakh bank officers struck work demanding unconditional mandate for the 11th bi-party wage revision talks. The organizers of the Ajmer Literature Festival have called off an event said to be addressed by Nasiruddin Shah after protests by right-wing groups over the actor's recent remarks on mob violence. The veteran actor had said that the death of a cow was being given importance over killing of a policeman. Bollywood actress Karishma Kapoor reminisces the time she spent with late actress Sri Devi while they were shooting a cameo appearance in the film Zero. The actress took to Instagram and shared a behind-the-scenes picture from the set. Zero marks the last on-screen appearance of Sri Devi, who passed away earlier this year. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from America and Punjab. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from America are: Defense Secretary James Mattis has announced that he would resign at the end of February due to differences with President Donald Trump over the withdrawal of troops from Syria and Afghanistan. Trump overruled his advisers over Syria withdrawal and declared victory over the IS. The Donald Trump administration has ordered the US military to start withdrawing roughly 7,000 troops from Afghanistan. The Afghanistan directive also came as the US was attempting to negotiate a peace deal with the Taliban to end the 17-year-old war. U.S. Deputy Attorney General Rod Rosenstein has revealed that charges have been brought against two alleged Chinese hackers linked to China's Ministry of State Security. The two hackers are suspected of conspiracy to commit computer intrusions against dozens of companies. Homeland Secretary Kirstjen Nielsen has urged that the U.S. should select the very best among the applicants under the H-1B visa. Nielsen told members of the powerful Senate Judiciary Committee during a congressional hearing. European aircraft maker Airbus, which is facing a probe in India on suspect payments to a consultant, is now facing an investigation by the US over allegations of corruption. Shares tumbled more than 9% after it was reported that the company could face record fines. India pharmaceutical major Torrent Pharmaceuticals has recalled 2 lots of losartan potassium tablets. Indian pharmaceutical major Torrent Pharmaceuticals has recalled 2 lots of losartan potassium tablets used to treat hypertension in the US market. The company has detected traces of unexpected impurity in the tablets. The US House of Representatives has approved more than $5 billion in funding for the president's border wall in its stopgap spending bill. The spending bill was approved by the House with 270 votes in favor and 185 against, only 8 of which were cast by Republicans. The US has told Islamabad and other regional partners that state support for terrorist proxies will not be tolerated. Freedom of movement of militant groups like the Taliban and the Haqqani Network in Pakistan pose security threats to Afghanistan. A Chinese chemistry student at a US university tried to poison his African-American roommate over a period of months. Prosecutors alleged that Yukai Yang laced the food and drink of Juven Royal with thallium. He has been charged with attempted homicide. A slew of Hollywood labor unions have come together to pledge to combat workplace harassment. The announcement comes more than a year after revelations about disgraced movie Harvey Weinstein rocked the entertainment industry. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: Lok Sabha MP from SAP Prem Singh Chandu Matra has demanded that the British government should apologize for the Jallianwala Bagh massacre that took place in Amritsar in 1990. The demand was made by Chandu Matra during the Parliament zero hour. CM Amrinder Singh has trashed SAP President Sukhbir Singh Badal's comments on the loan waiver announced by Congress in Punjab and other states. Singh has also urged Badal to give a political theatre and be a serious political contender. SAT candidates have staged a protest against CM Amrinder Singh and Congress MLA Kaka Sukhjeet Singh Lohar outside the BDPO office. The move came after a rejection of nomination papers of 39 candidates in the ensuing panchayat election. CM Amrinder Singh has lashed out at SAT chief Sukhbir Singh Badal for trying to drag the Gandhis into the 1984 riots. Singh said that if Badal was so concerned, why was he silent about the involvement of RSS workers in the riots? A Congress Sarpanch candidate has been shot at recently. However, the Batala police are still trying to figure out the identity of the attacker. Meanwhile, many senior officers are claiming that the attacker could be dreaded gangster Supreet Singh Hari Chatha. Fearing political backlash, the cash-strapped state has held back the decision to increase stamp duty on 17 services. 2 months ago, the cabinet had approved amendments to increase the rates of stamp duty to gain additional rupees 100 crore per month. The Punjab and Haryana High Court has issued a notice to Cabinet Minister Navjot Sidhu for interfering in the functioning of the Pagwara Municipal Corporation. Justice Jitendra Chauhan also issued a notice for March 28 to the state government. The Noida police have busted a fake call center in Noida, which was being used to dupe US citizens. A raid was conducted at the call center on a tip-off that dubious operations were being carried out. The Delhi High Court has dismissed the plea of former Congress leader Sajjan Kumar for extension of time till January 30th to surrender. Sajjan was recently sentenced to life imprisonment in a 1984 anti-Sikh riots case. The release date of the film Muklava has been preponed. It will be hitting the silver screen on 24th May 2019. Singer-turned-actress Amy Virk will be seen opposite of Sonam Bajwa in the movie. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-American businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at Indian Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
Actor Nasiruddin Shah, who has courted controversy with his views on the rising mob violence in the country, finds it strange that something he voiced as a worried Indian has caused a hullabaloo. Asked about being slammed for saying that poison has spread in the Indian society, where at some places the death of a cow is given more significance than of a public officer, and where he feels worried for his children, Nasiruddin told the media in Ajmer on Friday, I don't know why, because what I said was from the point of view of a worried Indian. And I have said it before also. I don't know this time what did I say to be labeled a traitor. It's strange. The Congress on Thursday endorsed Nasiruddin's views, while BJP representatives have called it a promotional stunt. Commenting on that, Nasiruddin said, "Yes, they will say so. And then you can say that it was the Australian team that asked me to speak against Virat Kohli." The actor said, "People will have to tolerate criticism. If they have the right to criticize, so do I. I am raising a concern about my nation, a nation I love and live in. I am talking about that and expressing my concern. So what wrong am I doing?" Asked if he has ever faced any Hindu-Muslim clash, Nasiruddin, who is married to actress Ratna Pathak Shah, said no. His comments about his concerns regarding his children and the current socio-political state of the country feature in a video interview with Karwai Mohabbat India. It was shared on its YouTube channel earlier this week.
Actress Karishma Kapoor shared a BTS picture from the film Zero, in which she has a cameo, and thanked lead star Shah Rukh Khan and the film's team for giving her the opportunity to share screen space with late actress Sridevi. Karishma Kapoor was extremely fond of Sridevi, who was also her all-time favourite actress, and got the opportunity of a lifetime when she starred alongside her idol in Shah Rukh Khan's starrer Zero. Both had a brief cameo in the movie. She took to Instagram and shared the picture from the sets of Zero. In the photo, Sridevi looked gorgeous in an emerald green sparkling gown. The divas were seen fixing their makeup before they shot for their scene. Karishma captioned, "Thank you Shah Rukh and Team Zero for giving me the opportunity to share screen space with a legend and my all-time favourite Sridevi. We miss you." Sridevi had filmed a scene before she died in February 2018, and this cameo in Zero is her last on-screen appearance. Zero, which is directed by Anand L. Rai, who also stars Anusha Sharma and Katrina Kaif in lead roles. Even though Sonam Kapoor is busy with her work commitments, she still manages to take out time to treat her Insta fam with her candid pictures. Earlier, she used to add pictures with her family and friends, but now Neerja actor feeds social media with pictures with her main man and hubby Anand Ahuja, that too with hashtag EverydayPhenomenal. Recently, she shared a picture with her hubby and captioned, "There is no blue without yellow and without orange. Vincent Van Gogh. Major missing everyday phenomenal Anand Ahuja." Well, looks like Mrs. Ahuja is sorely missing her husband, who is currently in London, while Sonam is shooting in India for the Zoya Factor. Besides shooting for the Zoya Factor, recently Sonam shot a fun episode for Karan Johar's chat show, Coffee with Karan, with her siblings, Riya Kapoor and Harshvardhan Kapoor. The pictures she uploaded too on Instagram with the caption, "Sitting on the couch with a beautiful siblings and talking absolute rubbish and absolute sense at the same time, something only Karan Johar can make you do outside of your living room couch." Sonam Kapoor and Anand Ahuja tied the knot on May 22, 2018 in a traditional Sikh ceremony, and later both families hosted a reception for all the Bollywood friends and family. The most anticipated release of the year, Zero, starring megastar Shah Rukh Khan in a role of vertically challenged Pawa Singh, is released today. Hemmed by Tanu Ved's Manu director Anand L. Rai, the movie Zero is romantic drama featuring actresses Anushka Sharma and Katrina Kaif. Anushka stepped in the shoe of a scientist, whereas Katrina Kaif played the role of superstar Babita Singh. The Anand L. Rai directorial is bringing back the Jab Tak Hai Jaan trio, Shah Rukh Khan, Anushka Sharma and Katrina Kaif on the big screen. Also, the film has cameos by multiple Bollywood celebrities like Salman Khan, late Sridevi and many more. Let's check out some public reactions.
Acting बहुत अच्छी करी थी उन्होंने इसमें मूवी में, सॉन्ग भी बहुत अच्छे हैं, वीएफएक्स भी बहुत सही थे मूवी में. हां जी, तो मूवी सुपर हिट जाएगी वाली.
बहुत पसंद आया न्यू एवेटर ऑफ शाहरुख खान. लग नहीं रहा है कि अब वीएफएक्स है. बहुत मजा आया देखने को इनको ऐसे अवतार में.
इट्स अ कंप्लीट एंटरटेनर एज इन टर्म्स ऑफ लाइक म्यूजिक एज वेल. अजय अतुल जी ने बहुत अच्छा म्यूजिक दिया है. सब ने बहुत अच्छा काम करा है. द डायरेक्शन हैज बीन फैबुलस. आनंद सर का बहुत अच्छा, और हिमांशु सर ने बहुत अच्छा लिखा है. डायलॉग्स बहुत अच्छे हैं. बहुत अपना नॉर्थ साइड वाला फ्लेवर है. वहाँ के लोगों को बहुत पसंद आने वाली है मूवी.
मुझे कैटरीना कैफ बहुत प्यारी लगी है. पहली बार मुझे इतनी अच्छी लगी है. और अनुष्का शर्मा ने तो बहुत अच्छी एक्टिंग की है. बहुआ लगा है, मेरठ का आरामी बंदा लगा है मुझे मेरठ में, क्योंकि मैं भी उधर ही से ही हूँ. मुझे एंडिंग थोड़ी बोरिंग लगी 10-15 मिनट की. वो थोड़ा मुझे लगा कुछ और भी हो सकता था.
देखिए, मैं उस तरीके से नहीं फॉलो करता हूँ कि यू नो आई एम जस्ट लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड फॉर अ फ्राइडे. मतलब ये सब डायरेक्टर्स एक्टर्स यू नो यू फॉलो देम वेरी डीपली, एंड देन व्हेन यू कम अप विद सच थिंग्स यू नो इट्स वेरी बैड.
काफ़ी लॉजिकल मूवी लगी. और ऐसे मतलब अगर आपको देखना ही है तो अपना ब्रेन बाहर रख के अंदर बैठिए, एंटरटेन होइए.
Now let's see the number of stars they gave the movie.
5 out of 5. 5 out of 5. 5 out of 5. 4 stars. 2.5.
After much publicity and wait, Anand Rai's Zero released today to a starkly divided response. Actress Priyanka Chopra and her singer husband Nick Jonas hosted their third wedding reception in Mumbai on Thursday. The newlyweds partied with some of the top Bollywood stars at Taj Lands End Hotel. Priyanka looked stunning in white embellished outfit while Nick Jonas complimented her in a dapper green suit. Salman was present at the venue. Earlier there were some rumors that he was upset with Priyanka for quitting his film Bharat. Rekha arrived for the party in her usual stunning Kanchiwaram sari. Kangana Ranaut came with her mother and sister. Newly wedded couple Ranveer Singh and Deepika Padukone looked mesmerizing in their black traditional outfits at the reception. Other top Bollywood celebrities like A.R. Rahman, Katrina Kaif, Parineeti Chopra, Karan Johar, Anil Kapoor, Anushka Sharma, Kiara Advani, Janhvi Kapoor, Sara Ali Khan, Ishan Khattar, Rajkumar Rao, Patralekha Zaira Wasim also attended the reception. Actors Kajol Vidya Balan along with her husband Siddharth Roy Kapoor and singer Asha Bhosle also arrived at the venue. Badminton star Saina Nehwal were also spotted at the reception. Hema Mali looked beautiful in a blue sari. Tushar Kapoor arrived at the reception with his father and veteran actor Jitendra. Filmmaker Madhur Bhandarkar, who worked with Priyanka Chopra in fashion, was also present. Actress Shabana Azmi and fashion designer duo of Abu Jani and Sandeep Khosla were also spotted at the reception. Priyanka and Nick tied the knot in Umaid Bhawan Palace in Jodhpur and had two wedding ceremonies, a Christian and a Hindu. Nick Jonas, who was in the US after their short vacation in Oman, flew in for the Mumbai reception. Scans
Accounting. A team of highly professional accountants, we deliver quality and immeasurable assistance to our clients. For Canada audit assistance and your business loans, the only name you can trust. A professional accountant always makes a difference. For more information, call us at 416-741-0801 or visit us at scansaccountants.com.